Self-Heard Call on this first weekend of Advent. We'll get going with our first song tonight, and it's called Love in Any Love in Any Language Indeed. And that's what Jesus Christ said, love your neighbor as yourself. This goes for everybody. We'll continue on with the grown-up Christmas list.
Do you remember me? I sat upon your knee. I wrote to you with childhood fantasies. Well, I'm all grown up now and still need help somehow. I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream. So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list, not for myself, but for a world in need. No more lives torn apart, that wars would never start, and time would heal all.
That wars would never start, and time.
Welcome to Upward Call on this Advent season, the first of the year. Happy New Year. It's the new calendar year, 2021, for the church, and this starts it all, Advent. Well, so welcome and sit back and enjoy, and it is Advent, so we are going to play Christmas music the whole Advent season. The announcements I have tonight is, as you know by now, that we are not meeting in person in church. This is all online, and the Sunday service as well is online as well. So I think that's what we have. If there are any meetings, they will be probably canceled or something. So please keep track of your emails that are sent out or the word you get. And if you need information, just call the church office. But as far as I know, all the meetings will be canceled and will only be held if absolutely necessary. So if you're on a committee, please keep that in mind. All right, at this time, that's all I have at this time, and we'll continue on with our next song this evening. It's called, here we go. This is Advent. I almost forgot. And tonight, we are lighting our first Advent candle of the season, and here we have Taylor and Sarah Osborne who will do that for us.
Today, we enter Advent, a season of possibilities, a time of not yet, but daily. Lives reflect human struggles.
Sometimes we are surrounded by brokenness in our lives, among friends and families, in our worldwide family.
Hope seems a far-off vision, yet we yearn for it to fill us. We cry together.
Restore us, O God. Let your face shine that we may be saved.
When hope is lost, restore us, O God.
When people are hurting, restore us, O God.
When nations are fighting, restore us, O God.
When children are hungry, restore us, O God.
Restore us, God of life. Bring us closer to hope, the hope that lights the way on the journey to Bethlehem.
During this season of waiting, may we be open to signs of your restoring love.
As we light this first Advent candle, let us pray God's restoration in midst of brokenness and despair.
Restore us, O God. Let your face shine that we may be saved. Amen.
All right. Thank you, Sarah and Taylor. Very good job. And as that, we start our Advent season, and we'll continue on with our next song this evening. It's called Christmas Like a Child.
Is Christmas Like a Child.
Christmas.
Christmas like a child, and I think that's what we all really want to feel. Here we go with the Worship Emmanuel Medley.
Israel, that mourns in love.
What a nice Christmas medley with that. Excuse me. And with that medley, all I can say is, oh, come all ye faithful.
And y'all make me proud. Sing it loud. Oh, come let
All right. Oh, come, let us adore him indeed. We'll continue with, oh, what a scripture lesson tonight. It's Isaiah 11, 1 through 3 and 10. Want to read along, please? A shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. On that day, the root of Jesse shall stand as a signal to the peoples. The nations shall inquire of him, and his dwelling shall be glorious. Scripture lesson for this evening, We'll do a couple more before we have some joys and concerns, and we'll do Strange Way to Save the World.
I'm sure he must have been surprised where this road had taken him. 'Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own message from the angel, come alive. And Joseph said, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here inside this tent? Just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say. This is such a strange way to save the world. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far. And as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Inside this table filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say, but this is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way.
Strange way to save the world, but Peter Ide says it was the perfect surprise.
Frozen hillside, stars so bright, shepherds shaking, blazing light.
choirs of angels, fear not our friends. In a manger, God condescends to us. God in heaven, can it be so? In a stable far below, Virgin Mother first saw the light on her baby's face on a cold, cold night. It was the perfect surprise. Surprise, but no one could realize he was born so that one day he would give his life away. What a perfect surprise. Come to me, gather neath the Christmas tree. Hear the story again this year of little Bethlehem and the midnight clear. Let us shine a thousand candles so bright, singing softly, silent night. Savor what we know so well, sweet mystery. First Noel, it was the perfect surprise. God's glory's gazing baby's eyes. What a perfect surprise, but no one could realize he was born so that one day he would give his life away. Perfect surprise, God's glory's gaze in baby's eyes. What a perfect surprise, but no one could realize he was born so that one day he would give his life away. Children, all you've heard is true, so won't you let him shine in you?
All right, well, like I say, welcome again to Upward Call. It's a first Saturday in Advent, 4 more weeks for Christmas, and it's a good time to celebrate. Joys and concerns I have right now, since these are all pre-recorded and recorded ahead of time, I don't have any up-to-date joys or concerns, so I don't have a whole lot other than this is the start of a new church year, so that's a good thing. The old year's past us. Let's go to the new year. It's Advent. It's a time of waiting to see what's going on. And since the new year's starting, we've got to wait to see what the new year's going to hold for us and how it's all going to work out. So all of you are at home. If you have any joys or concerns, please lift them up to the Lord right now and let him know what your feelings are, because he truly does want to hear your feelings and wants to talk to you, be in your heart, and be with you through everything you have. So with that, I'll say a short prayer, and then we'll say our Lord's Prayer together. Heavenly Father, we do thank you for this glorious season that we've had, the Thanksgiving season that just passed. Hopefully everybody at home had a very good Thanksgiving and got to talk with family and friends, at least over the phone or on Zoom or whatever they do, Lord. But we know that whatever their problems was and wherever they were at, whatever they were doing, you were there with them. You were feeling their feelings. You were going through everything they were going through. And we appreciate that very much, Lord. And we shouldn't have to have just one day out of the year to give you thanks for everything when we should be doing it every day. We pray all this in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Like I say, this is the Advent season, a time of waiting, a time of stories, a time of reflecting back on what we've done in the past, what you've done in the past at home, a time to get the old family traditions out and stuff like that, and tell stories. We all tell stories, and the Bible is no different. The Bible has a lot of stories. Isaiah was a prophet. He spoke with stories. When Jesus came, what do? He spoke with stories. Because I think he had the idea way back then, just like it is now. If you tell a story along with your facts or whatever you're telling, it makes it more interesting. It makes you think. It keeps you active on what the person is talking about. If they just give you a short yes, no, this is the facts, that's it, that's pretty dull and boring, and it really doesn't hold your attention, and you really don't think too much about it, I don't think, and I think it kind of goes in one ear and out the other, and you really don't stop to think about it. But if you do it in a story, that kind of holds your attention a little bit better, I think, and I think God knows that, and I think that's why he speaks in stories. It's just like if you was telling a story about you're going to your Aunt Elsie's house for Thanksgiving, and you start off with just the facts. Say, well, we went to Aunt Elsie's house, had a flat tire on the way to fix it, got there, ate dinner, and come back. That's not much of a story, and most people would say, yeah, okay, and that would be it. But if you tell him about your journey, and about the trip, and about the dinner, we went to Aunt Elsie's house. Part of the way there, we had a flat tire. We pulled off the road, and there was a lot of traffic going by, and finally some nice fella stopped by, and we got to chat with him and know him, and we fixed the tire. We made it onto Aunt Elsie's house in time for lunch, had a good time with the family and friends, or during this COVID time, it was just maybe a couple people over. And then you tell them about the trip back. Now, which one is more appealing to you? Obviously, for me, it's the second one. And just like when we talk to our friends, wherever it may be, we don't just give them the facts and that's it. That's kind of dull, and you don't like to do that to your friends. You make a story out of it. And I think, like I say, I think Jesus and God have this, and they know that. And I think that's why they spoke in the stories and parables that they did. And Isaiah the prophet did the same, spoke in the story. And this is what this is. It's a story. It makes you think. It gives you some facts. But it makes you think about them and makes you wonder about them and makes you keep reading the story. He spoke, out of the root of Jesse, out of the stump of Jesse, a branch shall grow from its roots. It kind of gets you interested, doesn't it? We have the luxury of knowing what that story is about. But back then, they didn't know. So they're thinking, what's he talking about? It says, the Spirit of the Lord shall descend on him and rest there in the wisdom and understanding, and he will be full of knowledge, and his fear will be of the Lord. I mean, he's not really fearing the Lord. The fear of the Lord back then meant that he understood the Lord, and he was going to obey the Lord and do everything he had. So it gets you more excited. This person, whoever it may be, is going to be special, very special. Says his delight shall be in the Lord. That means he's going to love the Lord with all his heart, just like we should be doing today. Love the Lord with all your heart. Just like the first song said, love in any language is still love. And if we love our neighbors as ourselves and the people around the world as ourselves, just think, maybe we could start a spark. It doesn't take much. What's the song say? It only takes a spark to get a fire going. And that's part of it. It says, he shall judge by what he sees and decide by what he hears. So if he's around today and seeing what he's seeing and hearing what he's hearing, he might not be too happy. We need to be in the fear of the Lord. And it's not only for, he did not only just come for the Jews. He came for everybody. Even Isaiah said, the nations shall inquire about him. Not just the few, not just the Jewish nation, nations, everyone. It's open to everyone. And I think that's part of it too, you know. It's open to everyone, and that's what Jesus Christ is all about. He did not come just for the Jews. It said King of the Jews on his crown above his head on the cross. Yes, it did. But it's not only for the Jews. Where did he do his ministry? He did his ministry out and about with the people of all faiths and all religions and nations and everywhere. It was for everybody, not just a few. And that's the way this season is. It's a time for stories, reflecting back, looking to the future, reading your Bible to see what the story holds. Because believe me, this story here means a lot to different people. Different people get different things out of it. And this is just the beginning of the story. We have another 3 weeks to go for the story before we finally find it all out. So just think how his story was, talking about the stump of Jesse and a root coming out. It will, all the world will be on his shoulders. He sees, he hears, he has the fear of the Lord. The nations shall inquire about him. That's a good story. Rather than, well, Jesus will be born in Bethlehem, end of story. That's not a very good story, and it really doesn't tell you all about what Jesus is, what he does, what he's about, and what we need to do to follow him. If you have Jesus in your heart, which I'm sure a lot of you do, then you do what you think you should do because Jesus did that. And that's what he wants you to do. Be like him. Be a friend like him. Be a good neighbor like him. You don't want to come to your last days and go up to him and say, I'm here. And he says, who are you? He says, well, I know you. And the Lord says, I don't know you because you do not know me. Because if you did, where were you when your neighbor was hurt? Where were you when their house burned down? Where were you when your friend needed you? Those are things we need to do if we want to follow Jesus. So when we get there and say, I'm here, Lord, he'll say, yes, you are. You are here. So this is just part of the story. So get your Bibles out, read the stories, make two new traditions for your family, because this is a season of traditions, right? Thanksgiving, Christmas, and all that goes with it, and making traditions and telling stories. This is a good one to start on. That's how our children learn. That's what God knows. You are my children. These are your stories. You need to learn. And we thank you for that, Lord. Amen. We'll have to do a couple more songs before we call it an evening. And I believe it is. We adore you.
Every heart bowing down, we lift you up.
And we do absolutely adore you and give you thanks from the bottom of our hearts. For our final song this evening, we're going to do Light a Candle.
Light the world, light the world, light the world.
Heavenly Father, we do thank you for the Thanksgiving season that we just went through. And we thank you for the Advent season that has just come, a time of anticipation, a time for wait and wonder, a time for you to light a candle in us again, to renew us in your ways. As we go out this week, let your light shine in us, Lord, so we may shine for others, and then they may want to shine for you as well. We pray all this in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ. Amen.